the reason why I joined ROV was because I do love robotics. Like, I had tons of summer camps that I went to where I was building robots, and so I sort of love that whole thing. And I mean, before ROV, I knew nothing about wiring all that. Like, every time I heard about it on a TV, I was like, okay, I don't get this. But now that I'm in it, I've learned so much more about it, so it's a lot more fun.
We actually like the ROV Club because it's really connected to engineering, and since I want to be a mechanical engineer, it's very fascinating, just like, you know, building it and stuff.
I really want to be an electrical engineer, but I want like another thing to put in my college applications that would like look good for that goal.
We're learning about all these like mechanics and robotics and wiring and circuits. Like, you know, it's something so complex, but like once we actually put our hands on it and do it, it's so simple. And then like it's a good feeling, and, like when we actually make one and like it works. And like you sit there and you think like, whoa, like I took something so complex and I made it, and it was actually easy and it was fun and I learned a lot doing it.
I really love going to ROV Club every day, wondering what to do next.
Since we have more equipment to add on from the equipment we had last year, we were able to do things such as have 8 motors on our ROV so we could give it more power to move around underwater. We were able to buy a mechanical claw because of the new challenges that we have. Like, the objects are wider. We have to get like a better grip on it in order to bring it back to the surface. And mechanical claw allows us to do everything because it has a large range where we can just go from any angle without having to move the ROV.
I love robotics. I actually want to be a robotic engineer.
Everyone does sort of have a certain job at the beginning of the class, and we just sort of work off of it.
You know, at first I was a little skeptical. I thought, you know, wow, the circuitry, I'm not sure if I'll be able to do it. So it was a challenge, you know, but with the Shed's help and just the way that they have the mentoring and the way they're always there to help you to answer questions, and it turned out to be really fun because I didn't understand that students really like to use simple tools like PVC cutters and drills, and to them it's just exciting just to be able to power the control box and, you know, have that drum roll where they see if it works or not, you know. So that to me showed me like, wow, this is not just like work, that it also is fun and it could come out to be like a learning and happy experience and not just so technical.
In the beginning you're sort of not really shy, but you're sort of unsure of yourself you're ever going to build your own little robot, but in the end, you accomplish something. You're 13 years old, and even though the teachers help you a little bit, it's basically only the kids with their hands-on experiment, ROV. And in the ending, it's very amazing for me because we actually built it. We actually built a machine that works underwater. I never thought I'd be able to do something like that in ROV, never.